first the rain goes to the roof and it gets to the gutter, and then the rain head gets all of the bird poop, sticks and leaves, and then the dirty water goes to the dump well and it fills up, and then when it fills up, the clean water goes over to the cistern.
My name is Blue Baldwin and I'm the Ecology Program Coordinator at Manzo Elementary. Manzo is a school in the Tucson Unified School District, which is huge. It serves about 60,000 students, many of whom are qualifying for free and reduced lunch, so at or below the poverty line. And Manzo is a school in Barrio Hollywood on the west side of Tucson, with a 91% qualifying population for free and reduced lunch. Back in 2006, hi Gabrielle. A person was hired to be the school counselor, and he found that in working with students dealing with issues around poverty and in a lot of crisis situations, it was most helpful to get those kids outside, outside of an office setting, kind of tool in hand doing something. And so he started working with these kids little by little on projects around the campus, and they started chipping away at building garden areas. And so the first thing that they did was build what is now a desert tortoise habitat. And so they planted a bunch of native plants. They found someone from the community whose grandfather was a retired stonemason and taught them how to build the wall. And this project was done literally utilizing just the students. They carried every single rock for that wall into the courtyard where it's located because there's no truck access for months and months. That was PE, and volunteers from the community. And so all of the ecology infrastructure that we now have at Manzo was built in-house with the students and the community only, utilizing small grants and partnerships with other community organizations. As all of these garden spaces developed across campus, vegetable garden, food production spaces that are very water intensive, the idea of installing rainwater harvesting also took root, because we do live in a desert and water is scarce, and we want to teach the kids that if you're going to be using a lot of water, you should be harvesting it and getting it from renewable sources. And so again, just using small grants, we have now 16 water harvesting cisterns spread across the campus, and those are what the students use to water all of our garden spaces. So the vast majority of our spaces are not on irrigation. They're just hand watered by students using those cisterns. I know that all of our cisterns are around 1,000 gallons. Some are a little higher, some are a little lower. And so 1,000 times 16, we've got about 16,000 gallons of water. And that will last us, they fill in the summer monsoon. And so we're all set at the beginning of the school year. The cisterns are all full. And those last us all fall until the winter rains. And then they refill with the winter rains. And then we can almost hit the end of the school year with what we get from the winter rains. And so we start wrapping up the vegetable gardening in late March, April, because gardening in Tucson in the summer is super duper water intensive. And also we don't have kids all year round. And so we sort of wrap up. So the water that we have collected in the cisterns from the winter rains lasts us pretty much as long as we need it to. So we use very little municipal water. I know that as a school, we overall save water compared to other schools. And that's also because we've deturfed a lot of our space. And so no longer is it a Bermuda grass lawn that needs to be sprinkled and irrigated, but rather we have a lot of native desert habitat areas, just mulch dirt areas, and then our garden spaces are consolidated. What I see at this school that I think is really special is that the kids love coming to school, and they're really proud of their school. I think they feel a sense of deep ownership because all of the ecology resources that we have, the chicken coop, the aquaponic system, all of the garden spaces, the desert tortoise habitat, truly are theirs. I feel like it's my job to make sure that the kids are able to really thoroughly explore and freely explore those areas, because in doing that they get to collaborate and work with each other, they get to problem solve, they get to know themselves better as people and what their role is in their community, And so Manzo kids love coming to Manzo because the campus is this rich, fun, beautiful learning environment, which is really special and unique in this kind of a community. So I think in a dryland area, if you're growing food, you have an ethical responsibility to be harvesting rainwater, both to conserve water, but also because the plants prefer rainwater. We have a lot of funky chemicals in our groundwater here, because it's traveled a long way to get here. And so we've actually had fifth graders do experiments where they water plant starts with harvested rainwater versus tap water versus water from the aquaponics system, for instance. And time and time again, we see that the plants prefer the rainwater and the aquaponic water over the tap water. And so rainwater harvesting, I think, is something that if you're growing food in the desert, you must do it. And there's this crazy statistic. Enough water falls on our rooftops in Tucson that if we were able to capture all of it, it would be more than enough for all of our needs, literally, which is kind of crazy. I mean, we only get 12 inches. But if we were able to capture and store all of it, it would be enough, even in that tiny amount, which is kind of mind-blowing. And then we also, as I mentioned earlier, we try to wrap up our gardening by the time it gets really, really hot. And then when we do summer crops, we do only the very native adapted dry weather crops. So we do like corn, squash, and beans that are from Native Seed Search, which is an organization that propagates native crops. And so those can survive theoretically and often in practical terms too, just on the monsoon rainfall.